is about blood and the second part is about lymphatic system. First, blood. So whatever the things that has to be transported in our body, like oxygen, carbon dioxide, hormones, enzymes, even the waste products such as urea, uric acid and ammonia, and also these are the nitrogenous waste products. At the same time, bicarbonate ions, protons, everything are get transported through the blood only. So blood will act as a medium for transporting the substances from here and there. Usually blood is the liquid connective tissue because it connects the body from one region to another region. And the blood consists of two parts. One is cellular part and the other one is liquid part. So assume the blood will be very similar to payasam. So how the payasam will be there? The liquid part and the fluid part. Sorry, the cellular part and the liquid part. So in the cells, we have three types of cells. One is RBC, other one is WBC, and the third one is platelets. So RBC, erythrocytes, because it looks red in color, that's why they called it as RBC, the erythrocytes. And WBC are leukocytes, means white blood cells, is leukocytes, and platelets. So these are the cells for blood clotting. So erythrocytes will carry the oxygen in the blood. Because of the hemoglobin present in the erythrocytes, it carries the oxygen. And platelets. Platelets are for blood clotting. Leukocytes, white blood cells, this was the main immune system which fights against the infections. And next, finally, the liquid part of the blood, we call it as plasma. So this way we will collect the blood from the human through phlebotomy. Phlebotomy means puncturing the vein, the blood will be collected into this test tube. After collecting the blood, it was taken through the centrifugal machine. Through this centrifugation, we will separate the solids and liquids, such as cells and liquid part. In the cells, you can able to see the entire red color part is RBC. And here we have the white color part. And in this white color part, we have the WBC as well as the platelets. And this slight yellowish fluid, we call it as plasma. And in the WBC also, we have five different types of cells: eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, and monocytes, lymphocytes. All these cells will fight against the infections. And let's see the medical terminology, what we use under the blood. Agglutino or agglutination, which means clumping of blood. For example, if any mismatching of blood transfusion got happened, such as if the person was A positive, if he received accidentally, he got received a B blood group, then his blood will get clumping, means little clots. That process we call it as agglutination. Baso means base. Chromo means color. Coagulo means clotting. So coagulation means clotting. Eosino means rosy red. And erythro, which is red. And fibrino means fibers or fibrous. Granulo means granules. Hemo is blood. Hemato is also blood. So hematology, study of blood. Leuko means white. Morpho means shape. And neutro is neutral. Phago means eating or swallowing. And sanguino is also blood. Thrombo means blood clot. Coming to the suffixes, apheresis means removal. So for example, plasmapheresis, removing the plasma from the person. Recently, during this pandemic period of COVID-19, so the person who got infected with COVID and got recovered, in his plasma, he will be having COVID antibodies. So to collect the COVID antibodies, we have to remove the plasma, and that plasma will be injected to the person who got severely infected. And cytosis, having more number of cells than the normal. Emia, anything related to the blood, we call it as emia. So next, globin. Globin means protein. So hemoglobin, iron containing protein. And penia. Penia means opposite to cytosis. Cytosis means having abnormal increase of cells. Penia means abnormal decrease of cells. Fill means attraction. So neutrophil, attraction to neutral substance. Eosinophil, attraction to acid substance. Basophil, attraction to base substance. Poiesis, poiesis means formation. So hemopoiesis, formation of blood. Erythropoiesis, formation of RBC. Leukopoiesis, formation of WBC. Stasis, stasis means standing still. So blood clotting, we call it as hemostasis. Hemostasis means the blood will be standing still. That means it is clotting. So let's see with the anatomy and physiology part. So on an average, we all know the adult human being will be having 5 liters of blood, and it circulates throughout the body in within blood vessels. So our circulatory system, we call it as closed circulatory system, because closed circulatory system means always the blood will be flowing in the blood vessels. We can't find the blood out of the blood vessels. That's why we call the human blood system as closed circulatory system. And blood cells are produced in red bone marrow. Red bone marrow is the place where all the blood cells will be produced, such as erythrocytes, leukocytes, and thrombocytes. And that process of production of blood, we call it as hematopoiesis. And blood is the mixture of the cells are floating in the fluid. So the cells are erythrocytes, leukocytes, and platelets. And the fluid part is the plasma. And plasma. Okay. This plasma, around 55% of the plasma is of, in the whole blood, 55% of the blood is occupied by plasma, and the 45% is of cellular part. In that 55% is also, 90 to 92% is of water. And remaining 8 to 10% is of dissolved substances. Let's see what are the dissolved substances. The dissolved substances are plasma proteins. Plasma proteins are albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen. Albumin actually helps for transporting the fatty substance. So you can also find out albumin, which is more present in the egg. If we break the egg and we put the omelet, that white color part entire is albumin. So we also call it as egg protein also. Globulin. Globulin is in the form of antibodies. We call it as gamma globulins. And next, fibrinogen. This is the fiber producing protein, helps for blood clotting. And additionally, it has the calcium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, glucose, amino acids, fats, urea, and creatinine. And RBC. So let's see the cell type one by one. RBC, we also call it as erythrocytes, which is enucleated. Enucleated means there is no any nucleus in the RBC. And the shape of RBC is biconcave. Because of the biconcave nature only, it can carry the oxygen. And the normal RBC count is 5 to 5.5 million per cubic millimeter of blood. If more than this 5.5 million, then we call it as erythrocytosis. Less than this 5, we call it as erythropenia. And it contains a pigment called hemoglobin. Because of that hemoglobin only, it is red in color because it has iron. And it is responsible for oxygen transportation. So the whole lifespan of RBC is 120 days. After 120 days, it will go into the spleen and there it will die. That's why we call the spleen as graveyard of RBC. And after death of RBC, the iron will be reused again by the body. And that bilirubin is the waste product that will be disposed by the liver. Coming to WBC, we also call it as white blood cells or leukocytes. And the shape of the WBC is spherical in shape. It will be having nucleus, large nucleus. And the count is 8,000 per cubic millimeter of blood. Leukocytes will fight against the pathogens, means whatever the bacteria, fungi, virus that entering into the body, that will be first line of defense is WBC only. And it has two types of cells. One is granulocytes and other one is agranulocytes. Granulocytes means inside its cell, it has granules. Agranulocytes means inside its cells, it doesn't have any granules. So you can see here, the granulocytes are basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils. just remain base, acid and neutral. These are the three substances. So the cells are basophils, eosinophils and neutrophils. And agranulocytes are monocytes and lymphocytes. So the basophils will release the histamine and heparin, very important during allergic reaction. Eosinophils will destroy the bacteria and increases. So eosinophils and basophils will increases during allergic reaction. And neutrophils cause general phagocytosis. Phago means disease causing agents. Cytosis means it will eat that bacteria or fungi or virus. And coming to the monocytes and lymphocytes, these are the chief immune cells. And you can see in this picture, this is eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils. These three will come under granulocytes. Monocytes and lymphocytes will come under agranulocytes. And platelets, which is very older term, we call it as thrombocyte. And out of all the cells, the smallest cell is the thrombocytes. So this, that looks like plates, that's why they named it as platelets. Around 2 lakhs to 3 lakhs per cubic millimeter. So if the count was less than, usually in the diseases like dengue and malaria, the platelet count will fall down. Then the person will become very critical. And platelet, it is for blood clotting. So we call that clotting as agglutination. And so the platelets will be leads to the formation of, when there was a damage, initially this thrombin, this was formed. So the thrombin will convert the fibrinogen to fibrin and that will form the mesh for the blood clot. Inside that mesh, the platelets will be there. Finally, it will clog the blood flow. So that will prevent the blood flow away from the body because of any injury. And coming to the blood typing, so I'll show you in the picture. Okay, we all know as we have the blood typing system, 36 different types of blood groups are there. But so far, we use only two grouping systems. One is ABO blood grouping system and other one is RH blood grouping system. We are combining the ABO blood grouping system and RH grouping system together and we are telling the blood group. For example, Subhash, what is your blood group?
O positive.
O positive. Okay. According to the ABO blood grouping system, your group is O. And according to the RH blood grouping system, your blood group is RH positive. You are combining and telling it as O positive. So let's see how we will calculate the blood groups. So we have the RBC and plasma. So this is RBC. This upper row entire things are of RBCs. And this is of plasma. Just remind, on the RBC, we have antigens. So on the RBC, we have antigens. In the plasma, we have antibodies. Okay. So first one is blood group A. So for blood group A, type A, on the RBC, they will be having A antigen. And in the plasma, the opposite antibody will be there, that is B antibody. So A antigen on the RBC and B antibody in the plasma. Likewise, type B, B antigen on the RBC and A antibody in the plasma, because the same antigen and antibody should not be there. If there is the chance, then there will be blood clotting will happen. In order to prevent that, we have the contrast antibody. And if it is type AB, both antigen A and antigen B will be there on the RBC. No antibodies will be there in the plasma. And if it is type O, so no antigens will be there on the RBC. But both the antibodies will be there in the plasma. So all the blood grouping system, so this ABO blood grouping system was named according to the antigens present on the RBC. So type A, it is A antigen will be there. Type B, B antigen will be there. For type AB, A and B antigens will be there. For type O, no antigens will be there. Okay. So this is how the blood grouping for AB. Next, among this, we call the O blood group as universal donor because it doesn't have any antigens on the RBC. That's why we call it as universal donor. And AB, we call it as universal recipient because it has all the antigens on the RBC. So O type can give blood to these three types. AB blood group can receive the blood groups from all the three types. And that also will be possible in the emergency situations, not in all the situations. Usually they will try for the same group only. If not possible, then only we'll go for the universal donors and universal recipients. Rh factor. So on the same RBC, if you have Rh antigen, then you are Rh positive. If you don't have the Rh antigen, then you are Rh negative. So Subhash, you are having Rh positive on your RBC. That's why you are Rh positive. For example, my blood group is A positive. On my RBC, I will be having A antigen and Rh antigen. And that's why I am A positive. In my plasma, I will be having B antibody. Okay. And coming to the next. But Rh positive person cannot receive the blood from Rh negative. But Rh negative person can receive the blood from Rh positive. But Rh positive person can... And let's see the word building part. Fibrinogen. Fibrinogen means fiber producing. Fibrinolysis means fiber destruction. Lysis means destruction. Fibrinous, which means related or pertaining to fibers. Hemoglobin, blood protein. Hemolysis, blood destruction. Hemolytic, anything so related to blood destruction. Hemorrhage means rapid blood flow. So if any major injury, they will lose more amount of blood. That we call it as hemorrhage. Any small cut, we call it as bleeding. Hematologist, the blood specialist. And hematic, anything related to blood. Sanguineous, pertaining or related to blood. Erythrocyte, red cell. Leukocyte, white cell. Thrombocyte, which is clotting cell. Granulocyte means granule cell, means presence of granules. Agranulocyte means absence of granules, means not a granular cell. Erythrocytosis, too many RBC, which is more than 5 million. Leukocytosis, too many WBC, if it is more than 10,000. Thrombocytosis, if it is more than 3 lakhs, then we call it as thrombocytosis. And erythropenia, less number of RBC. Leukopenia, less number of WBC. Thrombopenia, less number of clotting cells. Pancytopenia, pan means all. So all the cells will have decreased count, then we call it as pancytopenia. Erythropoiesis, red blood cell production. Leukopoiesis, WBC production. And thrombopoiesis, clotting cell production. And hematopoiesis, blood production. Coming to the vocabulary part. So, blood clot. What is a blood clot means? For example, if we had any, accidentally, we had a cut with the blade or any knife. So, immediately what happened? We will bleed for some time. Later on, our bleeding will get stopped. So, because in our body, we have natural blood coagulants, means natural blood clottings. So that's why the blood will able to clot, that's to stop bleeding. So how the blood will clot is, the liquid part of the blood will be converted to solid part. That solid part is converted with the help of fibrin and blood cells. So this whole process we call it as hemostasis, means the blood will stand still at that region. That we call it as blood clot. And coagulate. So, to converting the liquid part of the blood to solid, we call it as coagulation or blood clotting. Next, dyscrasia. Any blood diseases comes under dyscrasia. Hematology, which is a branch of medicine, particularly dealing with the diagnosis and treatment of blood related condition, and the specialist we call him as hematologist. So this is the electron micrograph picture of blood clot. So these are fibrin fibers, and these are blood cells that got entrapped in this fibrin. So this is the blood clot. Hematoma. Hematoma means the blood was collected under the skin. Suddenly, if we had anything got hit, like any sofa or any chair, suddenly we got hit. After some period of time, we can see a blackened area on the skin. So that blackened area was because of blood clot under the skin. Hemostasis. Hemostasis or blood clot, both are same. Packard cells. So in plasmapheresis, we have seen only the plasma will be transferred to person. But in Packard cells, they will separate the cells and the cells alone will get transferred to another person. That we call it as Packard cells. Whole blood. In the whole blood, both plasma and the blood cells, whole blood will get transfused. Hemophilia. Hemophilia was a genetic disorder where the blood will fail to clot. If the person is having hemophilia, for them, if the blood want to clot, it takes around 3 to 4 minutes. In that 3 to 4 minutes, more blood will get lost. But the normal clotting time was 1.5 minutes. That's it. But for them, it takes 3 to 5 minutes. Means they lose more amount of blood. So it comes from the families only. Hemophilia is genetic disorder. And hyperlipidemia. Excessive level of lipids in the blood. So which is having the risk of atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis means damage to the arteries. And next, septicemia. Having bacteria or their toxins in the bloodstream. So we call it as blood poisoning. And anemia. Any group of conditions characterized by decrease in the amount of RBC. If the RBC count got decreases, then obviously the hemoglobin will get decreases. And if the hemoglobin decreases, less amount of oxygen will be supplied to the organs. So this we call it as less amount of hemoglobin, we call it as anemia. Aplastic anemia, which is a severe anemia, there was the problem with the red bone marrow. So the red bone marrow will produce less number of RBC. So which was a severe case. These people needs their bone marrow transplantation, which is an emergency surgery. Hemolytic anemia. So results in excessive loss of RBC. Usually it leads to jaundice. And hemolytic reaction. So destruction of RBC due to mismatched blood transfusion. And next, hypochromic anemia. Insufficient amount of hemoglobin in RBC. So if hemoglobin is less in RBC, then the oxygen transport also will be less. Next, iron deficiency anemia. For example, we are not taking enough amount of iron from our diet. So iron is very essential for hemoglobin. So hemoglobin will not be prepared because of lack of iron. Then if iron hemoglobin is not there, oxygen carrying capacity also will decreases. So finally, this also leads to anemia. So this we call it as iron deficiency anemia. Pernicious anemia. This is because of vitamin B12 deficiency. So here vitamin B12 was very essential to make the RBC. If vitamin B12 is not there, then they may get pernicious anemia. Usually the pernicious anemia will be mostly to the vegetarian people because they will be lacking the vitamin B12 deficiency. So usually vitamin B12 is more found in eggs and liver and seafood. Usually they don't get vitamin B12 in a required amount. And next, polycythemia. Having too many RBC, we call it as polycythemia. And next, sickle cell anemia. This is also a genetic disorder. So like hemophilia. In this case, the RBC shape was not biconcave. It was in the form of sickle shape. So before 120 days itself, the RBC will die. The average RBC lifetime was 120 days. In sickle cell anemia, the RBC will die before 120 days itself. That leads to anemia. And thalassemia. this is also a genetic disorder. So our body will be unable to produce the functioning hemoglobin. Our body will produce the hemoglobin, but it is not the functioning hemoglobin. And next, so this was the normal RBC. This was sickle shaped RBC. So this RBC will live for 120 days. If this was the shape of the RBC, that usually will die very early. And leukemia, which is white blood cell cancer. So our blood cancer, we also call it as. So this is cancer to the red bone marrow, results in large number of abnormal WBC. And next, coming to the clinical laboratory test, blood culture and sensitivity. So usually, for example, most of the cases, the person will go for a blood check only. So in that, they will see the RBC count, WBC count, platelet count, and serum creatinine, serum urea, all these things, everything will be, if any infection also, if the leukocyte count was increased, if you see the COVID test or all the COVID-19 tests, they will go for the complete blood count. In that, if they found the increase in the leukocyte count, then that means the person is infected with some type of infection. Complete blood count. They will check the RBC count, WBC count, hemoglobin, hematocrit. Hematocrit means they will check the volume of RBC and white blood cell differential and platelet count. All the blood cells count, they will count it. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate, the rate at which the RBC will settle down at the bottom of test tube. With this, they will find out whether the person is having inflammation or not. Hematocrit measures the volume of RBC. If the, for example, in sickle cell anemia, the hematocrit will be very less because the volume of RBC decreases. Hemoglobin measures the amount of hemoglobin present in the blood. Platelet count determines the number of platelets. And prothrombin time measures how much time it takes for the blood to clot. RBC count measures the number of RBC. RBC morphology examines the shape of the RBC. And sequential multiple analyzer. So what and all the blood tests we are doing in this sequential multiple analyzer computer. So the computer will do automatically all the blood tests. WBC count measures the number of WBC. WBC differential determines the number of each type of WBC, such as number of leukocytes, number of eosinophils, number of basophils, number of neutrophils, number of lymphocytes and number of monocytes. And bone marrow aspiration. So in this, they will remove a sample of bone marrow and they will examine if the person is having leukemia or aplastic anemia. Phlebotomy. So to draw the blood, to draw the sample of blood for examination, we will puncture the vein. So the puncturing the vein, we call it as phlebotomy. So this is phlebotomy. Usually, if we go for a blood test, they'll puncture the vein. This is phlebotomy. Autologous transfusion. So autologous transfusion means, for example, if the person was undergoing to the surgery. So prior to 1 month, they will collect the blood from the person. Later on, the same blood will be used during surgery. That we call it as autologous transfusion. Means the blood from the same person, they will use it again. Blood transfusion. So which is an artificial transfusion, which transfer of a blood from one person to another person. Bone marrow transplantation. If the person is having any aplastic anemia or leukemia, they will transplant the bone marrow. Mostly they will take the bone marrow from very closely related to the family members, or they will check for the same blood group. Next, homologous transfusion. Autologous transfusion means from the same person. Homologous transfusion means from one person to another person. Plasmapheresis. In plasmapheresis, they will collect the blood and they will separate the plasma and the cells. And they will take the plasma and they will transfuse to that person. Coming to the pharmacology, anticoagulant, which will prevent the blood clot formation. Antihemorrhagic, it will prevent the bleeding. antiplatelet agent. This is also will prevent the blood clotting. Hematinic. Hematinic will usually given to the anemic person, increases the number of RBC and hemoglobin. Thrombolytic dissolves the blood clots. Thrombolytic will be usually given for stroke patients. Coming to the abbreviations, ALL, acute lymphocytic leukemia. AML, acute myelogenous leukemia. Leukemia means blood cancer. Basos means basophil. BMT, bone marrow transplantation, usually done for leukemia and aplastic anemia. CBC, complete blood count, means counting all the RBC, WBC and platelets. CLL, chronic lymphocytic leukemia, chronic myelogenous leukemia. So acute means it was the recent times, means if they get within 3 months. Chronic means if they are suffering from long period, means some years. Diff means differential. Eosinophils means eosinophils. ESR, erythrocyte sedimentation rate. HCT, hematocrit value. HGB, hemoglobin. Lymphos means lymphocytes. Monos means monocytes. PA means perinaceous anemia. Vitamin B12 deficiency. PCV, packed cell volume. PMN, polymorphonuclear neutrophils. Clot time means clotting time. RBC, red blood cells. Rh positive, if the Rh antigen is present, then it is Rh positive. Rh negative, if the antigen is absent, then it is Rh negative. Sex, segmented neutrophil. SMAC, sequential multiple analyzer computer, which is a computer test for the blood. WBC, white blood cells.